Hi, how's it going?
I know it's hard to play favorites, but could you give me share your top five episodes?
My top five?
Four or six, or however many.
My favorite is Perchance to Dream.
Okay, why is
that? I love that episode. Because the fun thing about playing Batman is the psychology of the character. What makes him so interesting, he's a guy with issues. You know, he's a very dark, complicated character. And that darkness came out of what happened to him as a child, seeing his parents killed. And he reconciles that by wanting to heal the world. That's what he puts all that energy into. So any of the episodes that dealt with the genesis of Batman, from an actor's point of view, it's just so much more fun to work with. So Perchance to Dream, he's drugged and he goes back into his childhood. And I was the voice of Batman, Bruce Wayne, drugged Batman, young Bruce Wayne in his teens, and then Thomas Wayne, father. So it was five voices in that episode. So I was really proud of that. And then Mask of the Phantasm, for the same reason, because he discovers what life is about. It's about loving someone and sharing your life with someone. And he realizes, in order to do that, he's got to be released from his vow to his parents. So he has that beautiful scene at the grave of his parents where he's begging them to release him. And at that moment, this flock of bats comes shrieking out of the ground, and they pull him back down to his face. And he realizes he can't escape. So those two are two of my favorites because they deal with the psychology.
Do you think Batman's need to heal the world is really a need to heal himself?
Oh, yeah. That's how he deals with those psychic wounds from his childhood. Rather than becoming evil, that's the whole question in The Killing Joke.
Yeah.
Can anyone be pushed so far that they become evil?
And one bad day.
One bad day, too far. Yeah. So, yes. His way of dealing with the tragedy of life was to heal the world, which is what's so ennobling about it. He didn't let it crush him.
Is there any comic book series that you would like to be involved with that would get adapted to an animated movie? Because I know you did The Killing Joke, but is there another one you could pick that you really want to do?
I've been saying for a while I'd love to do Hush. And they just announced they're going to do it. I hope they ask me. But you never know. Let me put a plug in now. I'm hoping I get it. I would say it's an honor, but that sounds cliche. But it is an honor. And I a great thing about the show is the seriousness with which the producers and the writers and the directors took the material. They never talked down to the audience, ever. And there was always a great respect for the audience. So to get that respect back from the audience means the world. It really does. It means that you touched something. And they got it. So I love it. I live in New York. I was crossing the street recently and this cop car did his siren pulling me over and I thought, seriously, am I going to get a jaywalking ticket in New York? Nobody gets jaywalking tickets in New York. This is unbelievable. And he pulls down the window and goes, Batman! We want our ticket. We want our picture with Kevin Conroy. This is great. This is great. So I thought only in New York. You know. But to have that connection with the audience, to touch that in people, there really aren't words for it. It's so incredible, especially for an actor. It's gold. It's gold.
He's so synonymous with redemption and with, you know, self-actualization and all that. I think you've talked about how you had some really amazing experiences with people who shared their personal stories and how, you know, the series affected them.
Oh my God, the stories I get. That's what I love about going to Comic Con. Stage acting. You get that juice from the audience every night, which is half the reason you become an actor. It just feeds you. It's like a drug. And when you're recording in a booth, you never get that. You create the character, you put it out in the ether, and you never get that feedback. Comic-Cons, you do. And the stories that I hear from a woman, a young 30-ish, in Chicago Comic-Con came up and just said, I just want to hold her. And I've always wanted to hold her. So I gave her a hug and she said, I owe you so much. You got me out of a terrible childhood. She said, I grew up in the projects on the South Side. She said, every kid I grew up with is either in jail or in prison. In jail or dead. I got out. And it's because of that. And I said, wait a minute. It's because of your mother, I'm sure. You know, I don't think that had anything to do with it. She said, no, I love my mom. My mother's a wonderful person. But she was working three jobs. She said, I was alone every afternoon. And I had you. And you were the one teaching me, or Batman was the one teaching me, right from wrong. It's amazing to think that you've touched a life like that, even if it's just my voice. But to have been a part of something like that, I mean, and I hear stories like that all the time. People lead such hard lives. They really do. Everyone has burdens. And so many children have such rough times. And to play a character that helps them somehow is really wonderful.
Sir, thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Thanks, everybody.
Thank you.